So we'll continue with electrostatics too. Very little remaining, okay? Very little remaining. So I'll finish that. Hardly 7 to 8 problems are remaining. And after that, we will stop. And then you have an exam. We do the combined exam. And then we start with capacitance, which is your next module. Now, please keep in mind, capacitance is part of electrostatics itself, okay? But it is a separate module for your JEE. Okay, capacitance is the next module. Do you have it? Please check that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today from electrostatics 2, we will continue. Okay, from electrostatics 2. Very simple questions are remaining. Actually, most of it is done. Whatever was to be done for JEE, it is done. But still, we will pick out few questions and then we'll try to solve. And as soon as we complete today, we will stop. Okay, ready? Okay. So, question, page number 40. Come to page number 40. Come to page number 40. In electrostatics 2 module. Okay, Malhar. Page number 40 in electrostatics 2 module. Page number 40 from electrostatics 2 module. Are you there on the page? Page number 40, electrostatics 2 module. In that, concept application exercise 3. In that, concept application exercise 3. In that, question number 1 is your homework 1. Make a note. Question number 1 is your homework 1. Question number 2, start solving and give me the answer quickly. Question number 2, start solving and give me the answer. Question number 2, start solving and give me the answer. Okay. Answer will be B. Getting the answer as B. Second one. What is the logic? The logic is a point charge Q is placed at a distance R from the center of an uncharged conducting sphere of radius R. The potential at any point on the sphere is, the potential at any point on the sphere is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. How did we get that? We got that because we know that potential is constant at any point inside the sphere. Therefore, answer is B. Everyone clear with this? Now, with the same logic, try to answer question number 3. Start. With the same logic, try to answer question number 3. A hollow metal sphere of radius 5 cm is charged such that the potential on its surface is 10 volts. What is the potential at the center of the sphere? Answer is potential will remain a constant. Therefore, potential will be 10 volt itself. potential will be 10 volt itself. Perfect. Therefore, answer for this also will be B. Therefore, answer for the second one is B. Answer for the third one is also B. Correct. Now, start with the ninth one on the next page. Start with the ninth one on the next page. Question number 9, page number 42. So can I say the options are not there, but can anyone say what will be the answer? Initially, the conducting shells A and B at potentials at VA and VB. That means there are two shells initially at potential VA and VB. Find the potential at A when V is earthed. Now, let me tell you something about potential. Potential depends only on inner sphere earthing. If the inner sphere is earth, then it becomes zero. Outer sphere, there is no difference. Okay, so in this diagram, tell me which is earth, inner or outer?
Outer.
So there is no difference on inner. So there's no difference on inner. Therefore, the potential at A will remain unchanged, or VA itself. But if the inner one is earth, then the total potential will become zero. Like in the next diagram, can you check? Inner one is earth. Okay, but now come back to question number 9. So can I say answer will be whatever the potential was before, the same potential will be now. Whatever the potential was before, the same potential will be now. Therefore, answer will be VA itself or unchanged. Okay. Now, what if inner one is earthed? Then it will be zero, but they will not ask you the question like that. They will ask you the question like how they have asked you question number 10. So start solving question number 10 and tell me if you can manage to get the answer. Again, they have not given any choice. So tell me if you can manage to solve and get the answer. Find the charge that will flow from the inner shell to the earth after the switch S is closed. That you have to find. After the switch S is closed, we have to find the total. Try it. Answer should come Q by 3. If you're getting the answer closer to Q by 3, let me know. If you're getting the answer closer to Q by 3, let me know. Anyone getting the answer? Q by 3?
Okay. Can you explain?
Okay. See here. A figure shows two conducting thin concentric shells of radii R and 3R. Therefore, you can see the screen, right, all of you? Yes. So
yes.
This is R. And this is 3R. The outer shell carries a charge of Q, whereas the inner shell is uncharged. So initially there is no charge. Find the charge that will flow from the inner shell to the earth. Once I will earth it, tell me the charge that will go. I don't know what charge will go. So I will find charge of the earth sphere. Okay, let it be QE. I don't know what is QE. So I have to find the value of QE in terms of Q. I have to find the value of QE in terms of Q. Now I know the total potential. Okay, the total potential of the system will be zero. Tell me why. Because the inner sphere is earth now. Since the inner sphere is earth, I know the total potential of the system is zero. Or can I say it is potential of the inner sphere plus potential of the outer sphere will be zero? If the total potential is zero, can I say potential of the inner sphere plus potential of the outer sphere is zero? Therefore, V equal to potential of the inner sphere will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught QE by R. Correct? Formula for potential. Plus, can anyone tell me what is the potential of outer sphere? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is V naught?
Q by 3R.
Because the distance is 3R. Now, I'm erasing this. Now, can I say the total potential is anyway zero? Is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common. Therefore, inside the bracket, I will get QE by R plus Q by 3R. Now, can you get me QE in terms of Q? Start. Now, I've come till the second last step. Now solve and get the value of QE in terms of Q. Ultimately, it's a factor of 3. Q by 3 minus Q by 3, Q E by 3 or Q is equal to Q by 3. Now getting the answer, Q by 3. So the options will be Q by 3, Q by 6, Q by 9, Q by 12, Q something like that. You have to select Q by 3 as your answer. Did you understand the logic of this earthing of inner sphere and earthing of the outer sphere? This is the way in which you need to proceed. Clear? Or should I do it? Or you got this logic? Got it? So I have done both the cases. One is when the outer sphere is earthed and one is when the inner sphere is earthed. Did you get it? Okay, cool. Now, come back to our exercises.
Sir, I'm getting minus QE.
That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Okay. Minus or plus does not matter. Minus Q by 3 or Q by 3. Options will all be in positive. What does minus Q by 3 signify? Can you tell me? And what does Q by 3 signify? Charge, it is only our perspective. Inner to outer, outer to inner. Just the flow of charge it signifies. But if the option is both minus and plus, then the answer will be minus. But in this kind of questions, option will not be minus. Option will be only positive. So we have to select Q by 3. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now, let me show you one notes. I want you to write this as a shortcut. I have not done capacitance, but I want you to write this paragraph even without that. Let me show you one. 1 minute. Okay, this is from errorless. Okay, actually, this is very good shortcut. Okay, actually, there is a long cut also, but for your entrance exam, we'll have to use the shortcut. Now, the shortcut is, listen to this. If n charged droplets each of capacity C are charged to a potential V with the charge Q. That means if many small droplets are combining to form a single droplet. Okay. In other words, if n small droplets are combining to form a bigger drop, then the total charge will be NQ. The total capacity is n power 1 by 3 C and the total potential is n power 2 by 3 V. Please remember this as your formula. It will help you a lot in capacitance chapter also. And one question over here also, it will help you. Therefore, I want you to make a note of this particular paragraph. Total charge will become NQ. Total capacitance will become n power 1 by 3 C and total potential will become n power 2 by 3 V. Total potential will become n power 2 by 3 V. Made a note about of this point. Okay, very important. Total charge NQ, total capacity n power 1 by 3C and total potential n power 2 by 3V. Now with this logic, I'll tell you how this shortcut helps you. See page number 69, question number 37. Tell me if you can easily tell me the answer using this logic. Page number 69, question number 37.
Yes.
Now you can apply that. Answer will come 9 times. I hope you understood how. 27 can be written as 3 cube. Okay. Now see, there is a long cut also. It is a work done formula. But you can save a lot of time by this. There are many. Like when you do a capacitance topic, we can do all these shortcuts. Okay. Now from a 3-minute problem, it becomes actually, from a 3-minute problem, it becomes like a 20-30 second problem. Okay. Now one more direct problem I want you guys to solve. That is question number 39. Quickly solve question number 39. Start. Question number 39.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you explain 37th question?
So tell me, 27th one, correct?
37th.
37 only. The one which you did right now, no?
Yeah, sir.
So look at the screen. Now the total potential will change n power 2 by 3, correct? Total potential will change by n power 2 by 3. What is n in this case?
Number of drop.
N is 27, correct?
Yeah.
So 27 power 2 by 3?
Yes.
Correct. Now can I say I can write 27 as 3 cube?
Okay, 9V. Yeah, sir. Got it.
Now you get 3. So that means you get 9V. Okay. Okay. Now start with 39. 39th one, everyone got the answer. I will show it on the screen. 39th one. Tell me how many of you got the answer for the 39th one.
Yes, sir.
Shall I do it or you guys got it? Got it, right? Okay, I should do it. Okay, I'll do it. A 5 coulomb charge, that means charge is 5 coulomb, experiences a force of 2000 Newton. Okay. Placed at a distance of 2 centimeter. 2 centimeter means 2 × 10⁻²⁰ meter. What is the potential difference? Now, if F and Q are given, can I say I can get E directly? Because I know E is equal to F by Q. Everyone clear with this formula? From our few table, I know that E is equal to F by Q. Now, what is F? 2000. And what is Q? 5. Therefore, can I say from here, I got E is equal to 400. Now, I want to find what? Find the potential difference. Now, I know the formula again from my few table. It is V is equal to ER. I again know the formula from my few table. That is V is equal to ER. So V is equal to, can I say 400 into 2 × 10⁻²? Because R is 2 × 10⁻². Therefore, can I say 400, 2 zeros and 10⁻²? Cancels and 4 × 2, 8 volt, which is option A. Just check, which is option A. Clear? Answer for 39th one is A. Level 2, question number 41. Take it as your next homework. Level 2, question number 41. Take it as your next homework. Question number 43. Quickly solve and tell me what should be the answer. Question number 43, quickly solve and tell me what should be the answer. Question number 43, all of you. Quickly solve and tell me what should be the answer. Anyone got the answer for 43rd one?
Yes, sir.
So it is direct again. So we have V is equal to X square plus Y square plus Z square. So now EX will be minus dV by dx is equal to, I will get minus 2X. EY will be minus dv by dy is equal to minus 2y, and ez will be minus dv by dz is equal to minus 2z. Okay, therefore the total field E will be square root of 2x square plus 2y square plus 2z square. So tell me, what will be the answer? It will become 4x square plus 4y square plus 4z square. Correct? Now on top, I will take 4 common, x square plus y square plus z square inside the square root. And if I take 4 outside the square root, it will become 2. And inside the square root, I will have x square plus y square plus z square. Therefore, answer will be B, all of you. Tell me if you're getting this answer. Answer will
yes.
be B.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Turn the page. Question number 48 is your last homework for today. And question number 50 is your last question for today. Question number 50. So solve it and tell me what you think should be the answer. It is a theory logic, but still we can try to solve it. 50.
Which question?
Page number 70. Question number 50. Page number 70. Question number 50. You know, as we progress, electric field will reduce, correct? As we progress, electric field will reduce because of the negative sign. So because of that, something will be greater than something else. So tell me, which comes first and which comes second? Because see how the electric field is going. We have done a similar problem with the logic. Rudra, correct. Very good. Sumitra, correct. Siddhant, correct. Rahul, correct. Peras, correct. Devansh, correct. Okay, good. Sakshi, just try once. Aniket, Riya, okay. Sanskriti, correct. Shayan, Akshat, correct. Okay. All of you are getting the right answer. That is good. So can I say as we progress, the field decreases, the magnitude decreases. Therefore, can I say x1 will be greater than x2? If there was x3, x2 would be greater than x3 also. If there was x4, x3 would be greater than x4 also. Therefore, can I say answer for the 50th one is B. Answer for the 50th one is B. Getting it? Okay.
Yes.
And there is one more type of question, which not that important, but it has come once. I will just explain the logic. Don't worry if you don't understand, but I'll try to explain. Tell me if you can understand. Question number 47. We'll do this and we'll stop for today. Okay. Question number 47. Try to understand some logic. Answer is C. Okay. Answer is C. I'm telling you the answer. Now, look at the answer, look at the question and think what logic they might have applied or can you come up with some logic for question number 47. Can anyone tell me some logic?
Sir, the magnitude of force in option that in that second one will be greatest because first of all it is repelled by the positive charge and also attracted by the negative charge. So two will have the highest for sure.
Correct. So can I say the second option, not the option A, B, C, D. I'm talking about option 1, 2, 3.
Option
okay?
2, yes.
So can I say option 2, it will experience strongest because on one side it is attracted, on other side it is repelled. Or nevertheless,
yeah.
Can I say only in option 2 it is placed in between? In other options, it is placed at the side. Yes. That means it is only encountering one charge. Here it is encountering two charges. Therefore, can I say option 2 should be the maximum anyway? Now, if I see that, can I say option B and option D are automatically out? Option B and option D are automatically out. Now, if you look at option A and option C, they themselves are telling us that first one is the second one. Got it? Both look at both the options. 2 greater than 1. Okay, very good. Now, 3 is stronger or 4 is stronger? This is what they're asking. 3 is stronger or 4 is stronger?
Sir, it will be 4, not because of repulsion.
Yeah.
4 is stronger because of repulsion, correct? 4 will also be stronger because of attraction between the first two. And third, the first two are repelling each other. Got it? So, fourth will be slightly stronger, okay? Actually, third and fourth theoretically will be the same because attraction and repulsion are not considered which is stronger, which is weaker. For example, if I ask you, which is a stronger pole of a magnet, it is both the poles are equally strong. Therefore, in this case, repulsion is slightly stronger because the first two charges are attracting each other. Check. Therefore, fourth is slightly stronger than third. With that, my option becomes C. Okay. Now, remember, if the options are not given, the probability is endless. Okay. But now, since options are given, I'm doing elimination. Okay. Very rare type of question, but still a type of question. Can you understand? So, I'm telling you, when any charge comes in between, that is always strong. So, automatically, two options are eliminated. Then you are confused only between the other two. There you have to mix and match and get the answer. Clear, all of you? Okay, perfect. So with that, we will stop for today. Be ready with capacitance and be ready for your exam. You have exam this Sunday or you have exam next Saturday?
This Sunday.
One minute. Yes. Always for us. Okay, I think you have combined test, no, this Sunday. Assorted questions, all chapters together. Okay. Next week, I'll start with capacitance. Next week onwards, again, you'll have two classes in a week. Like this, we was only one. I purposely kept only one because I wanted to get the test done. And you have got your new timetable for the next series?
No.
Right, you will get a new timetable also. Okay. And then we will start with our offline also, a little bit here and there. Okay. If there is a valid demand outside, we can do one of the modules offline during the day. You let me know if you are okay to come, or we can go with this way online. Okay. Mainly I'll come offline for our doubt solvings. Okay, whatever doubts you have for homework or for the modules, that way if you can come. Otherwise we can take an online class itself. So now I won't take your time. You prepare, you rest, whatever you want to do. Please focus on your Sunday's exam. And next week, be ready with the module of capacitance. Can you do that?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes.
So with that, yes, we'll stop for today. So thank you, all of you. Happy weekend.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.